were hit by a truck while riding a bicycle in Biddeford Friday night remain in critical condition this evening. Police say alcohol may have been a factor in that crash. As we reported last night, the driver of the truck, David Labonte, has had his license suspended 4 times and has had 2 OUIs. As of now, he is not facing any charges in connection with the crash. Following the crash, WMTW News 8 looked into Maine's driving laws, including those relating to operating under the influence. And what we found is that Maine is a state that does not permanently revoke a person's driving license, even if they kill somebody. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley takes a closer look for us tonight. Jim?
Well, Tracy, that word from the Secretary of State, Matt Dunlap, and tonight we hear from a Scarborough woman whose daughter was killed by an habitual offender and says Maine's OUI laws are still too weak.
8 years later, I could relive the whole thing over again. And if I wasn't the person I was, I would load a gun and shoot this person because he ruined my life as well as my family's and my daughter, who didn't deserve it.
Pat LaNigra is talking about that day in July 2005 when her daughter, Tina Turcott, was hit and killed by a truck in Hollowell. It was later revealed that the driver, Scott Hewitt, was a habitual offender who had 63 driving convictions and 22 license suspensions. He pleaded guilty to manslaughter in Tina's case.
Something that never goes away.
A year later, LaNigra lobbied the legislature in an effort to strengthen the laws on the books, and Tina's law was added. Now, if a driver gets 10 moving violations of any kind within 5 years, their license is suspended for 3 years.
If you have 2 OUIs within 10 years, then you lose your license for 3 years. It used to be 6 months.
Matt Dunlap, Maine's Secretary of State, says there are more than 1 million people in Maine with a driver's license. Nearly 50,000 licenses are currently under suspension. Many of the suspensions are for failure to pay a fine or child support, but others have been convicted of operating under the influence. And last year, there were 723 habitual offenders.
The question is, do we ever take somebody's license away permanently? And the answer is no. People always have the chance to get their license back. It may take them a long, long time, but they do have the chance to get their credential back.
And if someone is convicted in a manslaughter death, they can retrieve their driver's license 10 years after serving their sentence. And that's maddening, says Pat LaNigra.
To even say take the car away, take their license away, do this, do that, they'll still do it. A few, so many percentages did pay attention to it, but don't forget, these people are habitual offenders. They're just not going to stop and be nice people and obey the law.
And even Matt Dunlap admits without tying people to a pole, if they have a car and keys, they have the ability to drive, and the state can do nothing about that. Live in the studio, Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.